is Brian, KB8UIP and VE3SPG. And I just wanted to briefly talk about one of the issues I've had using DMR radio. And that is, I'll catch someone's call sign, and I'll do a quick look up here on QRZ or QRZ.com, and they won't have them. So what invariably happens is it's either a German contact, it's happened, and then a South African contact. So if that happens, and if I don't find them here on QRZ, let's just say we do a normal lookup. Normal lookups look like this. W6L, this is a club here in San Diego. This comes up great. It's got their address, all their information, very helpful. But if the person doesn't come up, let's say they're from a different country and they're not in the QRZ database, this alternate one here, this found the German ones, W6L. I'll just put in the American one here just so we can see what it looks like. And the only disadvantage with this one is you need to be a member and logged in for them to show you the actual address. So they're kind of blanking out the address here. But this worked well with German call signs. And then South African call signs, I noticed, weren't in at least two in a row that I got. Were not in QRZ or QRZ. So I was able to look them up here. I haven't actually looked up an American one here. Let's just see what it looks like. Not sure if it'll come back. The ones that I looked up here on the South African were ZS something or other, like ZS6, and that worked out great. Yeah, it didn't find the American ones. So this is the South African Radio League, looks like. And then the other case is that I haven't updated my DMR database, let's say in a month or something. And so the person's DMR ID comes across, but I don't have the database loaded, so I don't see their call sign or their name or country and that kind of thing. So then I just come over to radioid.net, and I do this all on my cell phone. I don't actually sit here on my laptop. I'm usually with my handy talkie, Anytone 878, walking my dog in the morning or something. So I just have it in the browser, just go to radioid.net, and I can just look up their radio ID and do a little search, and then it'll come right back with, you know, call sign and name and stuff. Interestingly enough, this did work with a Malaysian fellow that wasn't on QRZ when I searched them, but I was able to either put in their call sign or their DMR ID over here on radioid.net. At least I got their name and their city, so that was somewhat helpful. In that case, I was able to talk to the person. I just let them know, hey, I didn't find you on QRZ. I really wanted to send you a QSL card. And what that gentleman did is he actually went back over to QRZ and filled out his information. So that was it. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope that was somewhat helpful. So those sites, again, were QRZ or QRZ.com, hamcall.net, and then the South African one, you actually have to type this out. It's SA, you know, it's a secure site, or this one actually says it's not secure. sarl.org.za/callresponse.asp. You actually have to get that whole thing. The default starting webpage for the South African Radio League doesn't have the call sign search, so it's callresponse.asp. And then the last website was radioid.net. You could look up call sign or DMR ID. And that's only for people that have registered with DMR. That's it. Thanks for watching. Appreciate it.
Yo voy a cantar esta canción. Yo voy a cantar esta canción para mi gente. Yo sigo cantando.